Well, look who it is. Thanks for getting me out of the garden. I've been in some hostile work environments before, but Jesus. Of course, it's not like this place is gonna win any prizes either. Antique equipment, zero staff, patients lining up out the door. This isn't gonna cut it.
We're doing the best we can, Dr. Candle. Any suggestions you might have, I'm happy to listen.
I know, beggars, choosers, all that crap. What matters is beating this thing, but I can't do that without knowing more about it.
Here's a good place to start. Sarah is pretty sure Dr. Gordon Amherst had something to do with the outbreak.
God. That asshole. Saw him present a paper at Columbia once, he nearly started a riot. He's part of this. I need to talk to him. Anything of his you can find. Notebooks, laptops, close personal friends, I need that too. And we need to talk about live samples and antibodies. You're gonna be busy.
And you'll be?
Fixing this. Saving lives. Now if you'll excuse me, I'll get started.
What's good, YouTube? This is David from hitESC, bringing you part 4 of our Tom Clancy's The Division series. Now, last few episodes we spent immensely failing at completing mission number 1. So hopefully mission number 2 goes a little bit more smoothly? Let's just go with that. We restocked, we're all good to go. Actually, let's go build that wing upgrade that the tutorial was telling us to build. If anyone wants to say hi to Ra in the comments, he is sitting about 3 feet behind me.
Hello.
I don't know if you guys can hear that. He's a quiet person by nature. He's a very quiet phoenix. Okay, so each wing has 10 upgrades. So as you can see, each wing costs a different number of supplies. You get these supplies from either completing the main missions, which is where you get the majority of your supplies, or the side mission slash encounters slash whatever other little green triangle you see on the map, which are the virus lab research, hostage rescues, and one other thing, something to do with supplies. Okay, each upgrade built contributes to the progress percentage of the wing. So there are 10 upgrades: clinic, virus lab, disaster aid, quarantine, intensive care, hazmat unit, decontamination unit, pharmacy, counseling, and pediatric care. So obviously each one gives you different perks, different talents, and the game is forcing us to upgrade this first one, which is clinic. So hint, hint. Alright, so let's just hold down square to build that upgrade.
Looks perfect. I can't thank you enough. But I will bring you something from my wine rack.
Okay, so we have 2 new abilities unlocked. So we have the skill First Aid and the perk to increase our medkit inventory by 1 slot. So we'll just go over each one very quickly. So this one gives you the support station, which is very useful when you're playing a support role in the game. The support station drops a support station that heals allies and can be used to revive down allies. So when you put a support station out, your teammates can revive themselves, and that can come in pretty useful. You can throw it to them and then they can revive themselves, assuming they're behind cover. That's why you always want to try to, even if you go down, you want to try to make your way to cover. Unless you're getting the crap shot out of you, then you're just gonna die, and it'll take really long to revive you. You can't revive yourself when you're dead, so essentially when you're down and you need help. If you get killed in that state, you cannot revive yourself with the support station. The perk Protective Measures, which increases your virus protection by 1. The highest filter that you have access to in this game is filter level 4. There are very few things that require filter level 4, except if you're in the dark zone. When you go down into the subway, you do require a filter of level 4, no matter what dark zone you are in. Each wing has a upgrade that costs 1,000 supplies, which unlocks the signature skill for each respective wing. So the one for the medical unit is Recovery Wing. When you drop this ability, it will heal and cure the user as well as your teammates, and it will revive any downed allies within range automatically. However, again, if you die, as in if you lose all your health while in the down state, this will not revive you either. So it's kind of important to make your way to cover when you do go down, just so either someone can revive you or you can revive yourself with the support station. Next, we have Quarantine. We're just going to go over them again, like I said, super quickly. You have Pulse Mod, Recon Pack, Tactical Scanner, and Scrambler. So each type of scan or pulse does something slightly different. The perk for this is it will reveal all contaminated areas on the map. Intensive Care, which is more first aid mods. Hazmat Unit, which gives you access to mods for your support station and gives you another virus protection level. The perk for Intensive Care was increase your medkit inventory by one slot. Decontamination Unit will increase your Dark Zone inventory by one slot. I wouldn't really recommend using this one. I think this is like one of the last ones I would upgrade. Pharmacy gives you Shock and Awe and Battle Buddy. And the perks, it gives you a Rigor, which is to collect fabrics in the medical wing once per hour. And this also increases your virus protection by one. Counseling will give you the talents Critical Save and Shrapnel. And the perk to increase your credit gains by 10%. So this is actually something I'm going to unlock right now. This is one of the first upgrades that you want to unlock right from the get-go. You want to get as many credits as you can, and that will give you 10% more credits for everything that you do. And then our last update is Pediatric Care. So the talents for that are Combat Medic and Strike Back, and the perk is that it increases your medkit inventory by one slot. So the other perk that you want to unlock, or rather wing that you want to build, will be in the security wing, but it is currently offline. So what are we going to do? We're going to go do the first security mission, which requires us to be level 5, and guess what, we're level 6, so we're good to go. So let's just select that.
We're getting overrun.
This tunnel is the major supply line for food, meds, and weapons from the outside world. But we've got a group of rioters with explosives trying to break through the quarantine there. A JTF garrison is doing its best to hold the line, but they're weakening. And if the rioters blast through the floodgates, the tunnel floods, the supply lines cut, and a whole lot of people die. We've got confirmation that Benitez is there in the thick of it. We need that location secured, and Benitez back here at base.
Alright, so let's go save Captain Benitez, which we need to do in order to unlock the security wing. So you can see that it'll give you 700 security wing supplies. So like I said, you get the majority of your supplies from doing the main game missions. 385 credits, but we'll get a nice 10% boost. Actually, I think the credit boost is already applied there, if I'm not mistaken. Nice chunk of experience for early game. And we'll get Captain Roy Benitez, so we can start building our security wing. So let's do that. Before that, you can see it says they have one talent that's not assigned. So let's go to our talents. We have unassigned talent slots. So see, the next one unlocks at level 15. The second talent will unlock at, the third one will unlock at level 25. And the fourth one will unlock once we finish building our medical wing. So you have to have 100% of the medical wing built to unlock the last talent. So usually what I like to do when I'm playing with other people is to have the critical save talent equipped, because if you use a med kit, actually no, that's the wrong one. So this one will just help you with your damage resistance. When you're playing with a team, I like to use the combat medic, because if you use a med kit, it won't heal only you, it'll heal your teammates as well. So let's go with that one. And let's make our way to saving Captain Benitez. So you can see there, it allowed me to restock again because I have another medkit. I'm able to hold another medkit. Alright, so Captain Benitez is kind of far. But let's go save him. Alright, we're 0.3 kilometers away. That's actually not that far. I just wish... I feel like I've echoed this sentiment in previous videos. I just wish I had a bike to roam around here. But I can imagine I would get a flat very quickly. Alright, so we're making good time on this video so far. Just about 9 minutes. We'll try to end this video with saving... Not only saving Captain Benitez, but...
Warning.
With that cutscene.
Detected.
Let's just shoot these bad guys. And you can see there's a sniper right here. But I'm not gonna mess with that sniper. Let's just go save Mr. Benitez.
I'm begging you.
That guy was throwing up in the mailbox. Alright, so we're not gonna mess with the whole matchmaking thing, because before, you can tell, it was messing up a lot. It paired us up with a level 16 guy that scaled up the levels, which meant we got destroyed.
Captain Benitez requesting immediate support at the Lincoln Tunnel checkpoint. These
maybe down the line we'll do a mission
or two
with Raw.
If they blow the floodgates, they could put this whole thing underwater.
Alright, let's reach that security center. You can bet that if I die, I will be cursing. So let's try not to die. If you want to hear me curse, in that case... This is not going to be the time I die. Nope. It's okay if I die, but not literally a minute into the mission. Now we got snipers. So see, I'm going to play smarter than I did in that first mission. I'm going to use cover more strategically. But all the cover in the world is useless if I can't line my shots. Sniper will do a lot of damage. Alright, let's just chuck some grenades at them. I love seeing them scatter like bugs when I throw a grenade. Okay, the sniper is not dying, he needs to die. Okay, cool. I like the sound when you make a headshot too. Sniper is useless if I come up to you and shoot you in the face. Except in Destiny, but let's not get into that.
Captain! They're breaking for the tunnel! They're shooting everyone inside!
Jesus, it's like getting swarmed by locusts. Don't let them through!
That's a good analogy, Mr. Benitez. Should I call him Captain or just Roy or Mr. Benitez? I don't know. Probably call them all of the above.
Warning. Hostiles incoming.
Why are these guys hiding? They're gonna die. They can't avoid their fate.
Warning. Additional hostiles incoming.
Keep sending hostiles my way. They're all gonna die. We're all gonna bite these bullets. Who is this guy? You know what I just realized? I forgot. forgot to equip my healing perk skill. So let's do that now because I hate the sticky bomb. So let's assign that to L1. Okay, we had to detonate that. That was annoying. Alright, so healing and pulse. I like to use that a lot early game because, like I said, I find the sticky bomb pretty damn useless. If you like it though, no offense. That's pretty damn useless. Can I get up there though? Maybe. Let's find out. Convenient, there's a ladder right here so I can go shoot them in the face. Where'd that other guy go? Did he run away? Let's just punch him in the face. Let's not even shoot him. Oh look, more enemies for me to kill. I'm gonna die. Can they just kill themselves? Because this is. Whoa, how did that guy burn?
Right. Captain Benitez, this is Fei Lau. We are division agents, and we have eliminated the threat to the perimeter. I'm patching you into our comms so you can direct support to where we're needed.
That's good news, but we still got plenty of bad. Some of those bastards made it through when they're planting explosives on the tunnel floodgates. They're trying to get out come hell or high water. If those bombs go off, you know which one we're gonna get.
I don't understand. I thought we could not talk to Captain Benitez. I thought... So how the hell did Faye just patch into the comms and talk to you?
Listen, I'm sending one of my people down to take care of that bomb. Cover her ass.
Remember, you gotta rest some time.
Alright, let's just restock real quick. The thing that bothers me about restock, although I suppose it's a good thing, because then it would be too broken when you restock. It's that it only gives you your bullets back. It doesn't give you your medkits back like it does at the base of operations.
Hostiles inbound on your position.
Oh, that's what they're called. I always forget what they're called. They're called veterans. And the yellow guys are called elites. Take that pistol to the face.
Alert. Hostiles are headed this way.
Where the hell are they coming from? Like I said, be strategic, use the cover. Don't be like the meme. One or two episodes ago. Raw was right, these missions are kind of easy to do by yourself. At least if you're playing in normal mode. If you're playing in hard mode, well that's a different story. If you come rushing at me with a bat, I don't mind. But when they come rushing at me with a shotgun, that's kind of annoying. Why did the screen go dark? I still had an enemy left to kill. You guys can't tell by now. I like killing things. Just not the dogs.
Listen, I'm sending one of my people. Kill the rats and pigeons. Cover her ass.
Just don't kill the dogs. Wait, did an enemy make it to the?
Warning.
Aging with the bombs? Just maybe restart. Whatever, at least I didn't die. A little more experience doesn't hurt.
Alert. Hostiles are headed this way.
Can we just wait by the JTF person? I guess so. Could be straight too far away from... Him? Her? I thought it was a her. Actually, it has to be him. I don't think I've seen any female JTF agents. Maybe that's kind of sexist. I don't know. Let's just wait for these guys to rush us. They're all going to die either way. Get more loot. Oh, we're almost full. Somebody made it past me. Someone did get past me and killed the JTF officer. I didn't see their health whittle down, so that doesn't make any sense. Those bullets. Let's just get this med kit. Let's just fall back a little. It's moving too far forward is what made me restart this part in the first place. What I mean, they just scatter like little insects when they throw a grenade. Alright, fuck you, purple. Alright, timer's up. Should I just go kill this guy anyway? Yes, I should.
Damn it, that was too close. They don't care who they kill to get what they want. Come on up, and I'll meet you in the control center.
It's kind of funny that Benitez says that. They don't care who they kill to get what they want, because we're basically doing the same thing.
You gotta rest some time.
The Vision agents have no supervision. They have authority to do whatever the hell they want. Basically kill at will if they need to. So what makes us different from them? I'm not gonna care about getting all these phone recordings and stuff. We'll go back and get them eventually. Maybe we'll do a separate series on just that. For now, we're just interested in getting the story out of the way. Maybe we'll do some videos for side missions and stuff later too. And now I think I'm lost. Which is kind of hard to do since the game is telling you exactly where to go. Okay. We found Roy Benitez.
Jesus, what we got left. Glad to meet you, whoever you are.
Hope I don't have anything left. This time just me.
We got a hell of a fight ahead of us. Listen up. We got good news, we got bad news. Looks like we got division agents for backup, but these guys out there, they just...
Let's do some cardio before we kill everyone.
There's your goddamn bad news.
Alright. These JTF guys are beyond useless. One of these days I'm going to show you guys my favorite clips of how useless these JTF guys are. I really hate statuses because I always forget what consumable removes the statuses. It has this energy bar, but I don't have any energy bar, so. Also, I would recommend when you're going up against elites, which are the yellow enemies, don't be afraid to use your consumables. You find plenty of them throughout the game. And look at that, the water does 20% more damage to elite enemies. And I would recommend using your incendiary tools. Right there, we got a new lead. So let's just go ahead and pop this water.
Are you fucking kidding me?
a good chunk of damage. Oh wow, that's too much recoil. Throw another grenade in there. And that, what is that? Tear gas? Something. Just heal up, send out a quick pulse. And he's dead. Now we just have to worry about all these damn snipers. Bro, we just got a natural talent trophy. I know I'm naturally talented, you don't have to tell me that. Oh great, another bat guy running up to me. Don't let them rush me, JTF. Is that what you said? Why don't you shoot them then? And actually do damage. That would be useful. And they wouldn't rush me. Kill the asshole. There are a lot of assholes. Unless you meant me. I don't think I'm that big of an asshole. No, I need to be. Alright. I don't understand why the snipers are climbing down. It's like they know I'm gonna go up there and just shoot them in the face. You guys scared of me. You don't have to be scared. I'll try to make your deaths as painless as possible. But I don't know how painless you can make a death with bullets. Especially since I can't one-shot them.
Agent, your playmates have a sniper positioned ahead. Keep your eyes open.
Uh-oh. Alright, that's too much damage. Let's hide. Snipers do way too much damage. I personally do not like using a marksman rifle, but I feel like it would be important to at least have one person that does, if you're playing together in a group. You know, take advantage of the fact that you can play with three other people. Each person can have a different role, different maybe in support roles. I personally like to play more of a support role and a healer in this game. This guy's gonna try to keep sniping me, but I'm not gonna let him anymore. Alright, let's just take out this one last red bar. Oh no, there are two left. Are there more of them? Oh no, we got some veterans out. Oh, they're gonna meet the same fate anyway. Damn it. I hate the recoil on these guns early game. Alright, that was our last medkit, so it's now or never. Just taking this guy out. Just let him burn. Got that incendiary grenade up there. And he's dead. And we just got an error. Okay guys, I'm back. If you saw what happened, we're probably gonna edit this out so that you're not gonna see what happened, but I got an error and the application shut down. However, thankfully when we booted it back up, it took us to this screen, so right after the completion of the mission, pretty much. Although, yeah, it actually took me back right to the exact same spot where I killed the guy, so Let's get our loot. And let's travel back to the base and talk to Roy Benitez. Just pick up this medkit, although we don't really need it at this point. And I guess we'll make our way to the safe house later at some point. So let's go unlock the security wing. Let's fast travel to the post office. Why can't you just put base of operations in the big letters? Looks cooler. I don't know about you guys, but it's happened a lot more times than I'd care to admit, where I've pressed square to fast travel and I wonder to myself, wow, gee, this is taking really long, and I forgot to press X. So, okay, it's really snowy. Let's go talk to Roy Benitez. Unlock this medical wing. I'll tell you guys the upgrade I was talking about, and then we'll wrap this video up. So let's just slowly make our way over to Captain Benitez, and you guys can sit back and enjoy.
Hey.
Come on over. Captain Benitez even found some fresh coffee.
I just happened to walk by what's left of Kerman's. So what we're responsible for is Midtown to Lower Manhattan, mainly because nobody can get off of this island right now, including us. The biggest problem we have is manpower, or lack thereof. Right now we got criminal elements occupying and controlling most of these neighborhoods.
Rikers, cleaners, street gangs.
Yeah, I don't have enough people to secure a block, much less maintain order and safety, so basically these assholes are running around taking whatever they want and killing whoever they want because we got nobody to stop them.
Which means we get the task of cleaning up these neighborhoods, so we can at least get food and medical aid to the residents.
I don't know. I mean, an area this size, this many bad guys, I don't think you people can handle it alone. I mean, no offense. I just don't like the idea of throwing you to the wolves.
Captain, we are the wolves.
Right. Well, then maybe you can convince the division to send more of your guys.
For the time being, what you see is what you get.
I can't believe I'm begging the feds to take over my city.
Any intel we receive, you'll be the first to know. Good luck.
This isn't just your city, Captain Benitez. All these agents are basically sleeper agents that were activated that were already here. So, yeah, technically, this is our city too. And being from New York, I can say this is my city as well. But let's get back to this upgrade. So, I want to go ahead, use the laptop. You're going to be forced to build the first upgrade. Alright, each wing has 10 upgrades. We know that. So let's go ahead and build the situation room. Alright.
This is great. With this stuff installed, we can really take care of business. You done good, kid.
Alright, so what you want, let me just find it, because I forget what it is. Was it a K-9 unit? No. Huh, now that I think about it, the mission... Oh, okay, so never mind. You actually, it's the first upgrade that you have to unlock, so my mistake on that. So it's kind of automatic, so you want to get the security mission out of the way right after the medical mission, because you get increased experience gained from all activities by 10%. And you get smart cover, which is basically like a mobile cover. Well, no, it reinforces a cover and increases the damage that you're putting out and decreases all incoming damage for anyone who hides behind the cover that you put out. So obviously that's really important, again, when you're playing as a team or even by yourself. So that's actually... Let's go ahead and use that. Personally, I never used that before, but now that I think about it, that actually looks like a very useful ability. So let's go ahead and equip smart cover to our R1 skill. We'll clear our inventory off video. And right now there's nothing left to do. So next time we're gonna go tackle the Hudson refugee camp. So we're almost level 7. We'll get up to level 7, tackle that mission, and take care of business. Alright, so that does it for this episode, guys. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Leave a comment if you want. most importantly, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't. Go take a look at our other content. You're going to love it. This is David from hitESC, and I will see you next time.